Earlier today, the family of a local hit-and-run victim buried their brother and their son.
And tonight, they're making a desperate plea for anyone with information to come forward and help solve this case. WLKY's Lauren Adams joins us now with more. Lauren?
Rick, the hope was the victim would eventually recover enough to talk with police about what happened that night, but Michael Overton passed away Tuesday. Now this case getting solved and one family getting answers depends on the public's help.
We get together every Sunday for Sunday dinner.
But for the past five Sundays, Stephen Overton's uncle Michael hasn't been at those dinners. He's been in a hospital bed, the victim of a hit and run. Overton died Tuesday. The family is dealing with their loss and looking for answers. The driver didn't stop and hasn't come forward.
That's a big part of it. I mean, because if we knew, you know, it could bring a little bit of comfort, a little bit of closure.
61-year-old Overton was at the R&R bar with his brother back on September 7th. He left on a bicycle. He was less than a mile from his home when he was hit.
I'm looking out the window and I see all these police cars and I see an ambulance.
It happened on Springdale Drive, Terry Clyatt Street.
But I couldn't understand why the police kept walking way up the street and coming back with flashlights. I didn't understand that's where he was actually hit.
According to police, Michael Overton was hit and then his body and bicycle were dragged several hundred yards down this road.
Where we saw him was where he ended up. It wasn't where he was hit, it's where he ended up. So that makes it even worse that someone knew they had to have hit him, they had to have known it.
Just the way that he was left, you know, nobody deserves to be done like that. Nobody deserves to die like that.
It's a cold-blooded act Michael's mother is struggling to come to terms with.
He suffered too much.
And now her grandson says she's the one that's suffering.
Do it for my grandmother, do it for our family. Turn yourself in. This is all we ask.
It was another driver that night who called police around 3:20 Sunday morning. The caller at first thought it was a pile of clothes by the side of the road. That driver did not see anything, but police and family are confident there was someone out there that did, and tonight that's what they're counting on. Lauren Adams, WLKY News.
All right, thank you, Lauren. Here's a little more. Overton's bike was never located. It's thought that the driver removed it from the scene. Now, the bike is described as a silver Schwinn 10-speed with a large black seat. Anyone who has seen a bicycle fitting that description or has any other information is asked to call Jeffersonville Police at 812-218-TIPS.